So in the last video, I showed you how to create your own custom ringtones in GarageBand. But you could also take audio from existing music. Now it doesn't work with all music, but it works with some of the things you've got in iTunes. So let's go into GarageBand. I'm going to create a new song. And I'm going to start with the audio recorder because I don't really actually want to record anything. And audio recorder is the easiest way. I'm just going to tap voice there to get in and then get out. I'm going to tap that button to go to the tracks at the upper left, so I haven't actually recorded anything. Now I'm going to add a loop, and there's the loop button there. Now you can add Apple loops, and there's all these different cool loops Apple's got. If you played around with GarageBand, you know these are the building blocks you use to create music. But you could also go to audio files, which will look for files that you've got stored in iCloud Drive. So if you want to bring in your own audio from your Mac, store audio files in iCloud Drive, and then you can bring them in this way. But if you go to music, you can go into your iTunes collection, and here I've created a playlist with some music in it, and you can select songs from here. Now here's the thing, not all songs are going to work. What's not going to work, Apple Music stuff that's streaming audio, that's not going to work. Stuff that's protected in some ways not going to work. But I tested songs that I ripped from CDs that I own, and they worked. And I tested songs that I purchased in iTunes, and they work. And here's one I just downloaded as an audio file, and this one works as well. I can tap and hear it play, but I could also tap and drag into the GarageBand timeline. And there's the song. And I can play it, and now at this point I can export that as a ringtone. But I probably want to work with it a little bit more. So let's start working with it here. I'm going to expand a little bit by zooming out. I'm going to select just a portion of this. So I'm going to tap in here, double tap in there, hit split, and then I can move this around to get a area I want to split. I can then move over here, get an area I want to split. I'm not going to try to do it perfectly here, but you can play around with it and get just what you want. Then I'm going to delete these sections here and move this section over, just to get that little selection of that piece. And I can add more tracks, I can mix tracks, I can do all sorts of different things. But the bottom line is that I've taken a piece of audio from iTunes and brought it into GarageBand, and now I have my own project. I can exit here and I can tap the name there and name it. Then I'll hit select. Select that song, share it as a ringtone, and I will export it. And now it's going to be available in Ringtones. So now if I look in Sound and Haptics here, I can see, I can change my ringtone, and there is that song.